Welcome to Amazing Business Radio with best-selling author and customer service and business expert, Shep Hyken. Shep will talk with some of the smartest thinkers in business to help make you more successful in your professional and personal life. This is Amazing Business Radio with Shep Hyken.
Hello, everybody. It's Shep Hyken here. We're back with another episode of Amazing Business Radio. We have a guest that's been here twice before, so this is her third time. It is Katie Maris, who is the author of the number one best-selling book, Customer Experience. Now, while Katie talks a lot about selling to women and the power that women have behind decisions in lots of areas, today we're going to really be focusing on something that I heard her talk about at a conference just recently, and that is her five-star experience, the five steps it takes to create that five-star customer experience. Now, before we get into the interview, you know some of these announcements coming up, but basically here they are. If you have an amazing customer service story that you want to share or a question that you want to ask, be sure to just reach out to me on any social media channel. I'm everywhere. And if you use the hashtag AskShep, if you have a question, I'll jump in right away. I'll either answer it right there. I'll email you. I will answer it on this show, maybe on my TV show, which is Be Amazing or Go Home. And episodes can be found on Apple TV, Roku, Amazon Prime. And if you go to beamazing.tv, that is beamazing.tv, you can catch all the episodes. Just watch them one right after the other and binge. Lots of fun, great information, and I have fun doing that show. Anyway, we're in season three, I think episode six right now. Great show. So let's get into the interview with Katie Maris. Katie, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. I'm so excited to be back.
And that's what I should have said. Welcome back to the show. You're a three-peat now offender of the show, and we love having you on here. And what intrigued me about the last times that we've talked is that you have a specialty, and that is selling to women. And I just envision, I mean, I know I've recommended you to a couple of people or clients that talk about selling in the automotive world to women, because that was a lot of what your work was. If I remember when we first met, you were doing a lot of work in the automotive industry.
Yes. So for sure, it's the most male-dominated space on planet Earth. The experience is designed by men, delivered by men, for men, and women are the ones that influence the purchase. So there's a huge disconnect. So yes, they need my help. So I'm out in that space.
All right. Well, today we're going to talk about customer service and experience. I was recently at CCW, which is the largest association for the contact center, contact support world. You were one of the speakers. You were doing a program. You were talking about the five-star experience. That's part of what I want to talk to you about today. I want you to share with us what it takes, those five steps to create a five-star experience. So we're kind of giving a hint as to what's going to happen later in the show. But right now, you made a statement that I want to, I guess, get clarity on. I want your opinion on. I want your insight, because I think it's big. You believe that the power of experience will double revenue in 36 months when companies take that focus, when they focus on customer experience. So I want to know why you think that, because who wouldn't want that? In the next 3 years, right? I can double my revenue. I'm happy if I get 10%, but you know, in each year, which would be a 30% increase, but you're talking about doubling. Talk to me, girl. How does that work?
Oh my gosh. Well, I mean, here, a lot of the times we forget as businesses that our customers are humans. They need and crave and want an experience. And we get so wrapped up and we think our sales system and processes are, you know, going to get us that experience. But the reality is it doesn't. It makes it a little bit smoother. Now, if you elevate that experience and you create that trust and you lead a path, or you lead your customer down a path towards loyalty and referrals, that means that your revenue, purely by repeat shopping and the increased amount of referrals, will continuously grow at a rapid rate. A lot of organizations, and I mean, there are so many businesses in the world. So, I mean, we've got the ones that have it figured out. We've got, you know, the Nordstrom, the Starbucks, the Chick-fil-A's of the world. We know that they've got that experience down pat. People come back, they're brand evangelists, they refer them, they'll only go to their local Starbucks or their local Chick-fil-A, or they go see their person at Nordstrom. if more businesses tapped into that, because they're not doing it right now. So if more businesses tapped into that, they would see a skyrocket difference in their revenue.
Yeah, I think that. So I hear what you're saying. I'm going to kind of layer something on here. By the way, I love that you say if more businesses would do it, because many businesses don't, but the ones that do are the ones that are giving us the numbers and the data to prove that doing a certain level of experience gets higher referrals, gets higher retention. And if you start to read all the stats and facts, customers who come back again and again, even if they're not loyal, if they're loyal, it's a whole nother level. But if they just are good repeat customers, they spend more every time they come back. And then the loyalty is all about, you know, creating evangelism where they'll tell their friends, their neighbors, their family, their colleagues at work. So there's a tremendous opportunity. So what you were getting to, though, I just want to know, is there a specific industry that you feel this is really, really a powerful statement for? Or is it across the board? I know it, not every industry reacts the same way, is what I'm saying. So is there particular industries that you have found in your work that this really applies to?
So I think it's every industry, to be honest. Hospitality is a little harder to get that, that, you know, increase that double revenue, that travel hospitality industry. But, you know, in terms
why is that? Why do you think that is?
Because the spend is already so high.
But wouldn't it make sense that maybe I only take a couple of trips, maybe one trip a year, but if my airline treats me right, I'm coming back to that airline and not going around looking at other airlines. If the hotel, whenever I go to visit my aunt in Florida, because I won't stay at her home, I'd rather stay at a hotel. I don't have an aunt in Florida, but if I did, I probably wouldn't want to stay with her. But isn't that like, well, this hotel treated me right, I'm coming back?
Oh, 1,000%. So the loyalty, and I'm thinking more like on a day-to-day spend where we look at customers that are visiting restaurants or visiting
on a regular basis,
on a regular spend. I think that the ticket price is already so elevated that it's harder to get that increase in average ticket sale per customer. But yes, from a loyalty perspective, a coming back perspective, it's every single industry. I mean, if you love an experience, you're going to go back. I have this one restaurant local in Toronto, and it's called La Veranda, and it's a mom and pop Italian restaurant. My kids love it. When we go out to eat, we go back there every single time.
Now,
that's where they go.
Earlier in our conversation, you said women were the driving force behind decisions. It sounds to me like children are the driving force behind La Veranda.
Yeah, but guess who took them? Guess who took them to La Veranda? I did. Yes. And it makes them happy, which makes mom happy. And so therefore, mom is going to spend that money and take them out that way. But when it comes to also that doubling of your revenue, women, you can't ignore it, because women influence $43 trillion of worldwide spending annually. And we influence 3 to 4 generations of spending. So when you provide an experience to her, so not only are you getting her loyalty, not only is she coming back and spending more, she is referring you to everyone in her orbit. And when that compounds, it's very easy to increase that top line revenue.
Do men refer as often as women? It sounds to me like you're saying that women are a higher level of referral businesses that they
women
work
refer
with.
25 to 35% more than men.
Wow. Interesting. Yeah. By the way, I should mention, and we talked about this the last time you were on, or maybe it was the first time you were on, we talked about your book, Customer Experience. You know, it's like customer with an H in it. And I thought it was misspelled till I got to know you. I'm just kidding. I knew you were.
No, a lot of people do that. That's the whole point, is to be a little cheeky like that.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. All right, let's shift topics. Let's talk a little bit about humans and AI. And there is this, all I could say is there's this incredible amount of technology that's just dropping into our laps. It's such a reasonable price compared to what it was before. And now companies are adapting it. And some companies, they have the balance. Others, they go too far. And by the way, then there are others that are laggards. And I fear for them, because they can't keep up if they get too far behind. They just pretty much have to start over.
Mm-hmm. For sure. Well, I was out at CCW Austin, like we mentioned earlier, and I had like standing room only packed event because I was talking about the 5-star experience. So everyone's coming in, sitting down. They're so like the energy is great. And I say, I have to be honest. And the room goes quiet. Like, I will not be speaking about AI or
And
technology.
they cheered.
They
They
cheered.
erupted with applause.
Oh, they did. They literally erupted because the reality is your customers are not bots, they're humans. And we still need to give a human experience because people do business with people, not business. And I know I'm preaching to the choir with you here on this ship, but I think there is this balance that needs to be found with technology, AI, ChatGPT, whatever you want to call it, all the different nuances and the technology that's dropping into our labs, and the human connection. And there is a space for technology. Like you said, I also agree. I worry about the organizations that aren't using technology right now because they're gonna be so far behind. But the ones that are going on the opposite end of the spectrum are also losing out because we want to talk to humans. We want to interact with humans. We want that experience that evokes a feeling, an emotion that drops the dopamine, the serotonin, the oxytocin. We want and need that. We are already bombarded with technology in our day-to-day lives. I mean, we run our lives by it. So when we get a human on the phone or we see a human in a brick and mortar store, we do erupt and cheer because we're actually interacting as humans.
It could be a mental eruption,
There we
internal
go.
eruption. Not
Internal.
like we don't like jump for
I
joy. Oh my God,
don't
I've
know. I
actually
jump for
found an
joy.
employee here. Okay, which is great. Now, you bring up a good point. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, you mentioned some businesses go too far. That's where I want to start, and then I want to move into the 5 steps to create the 5-star experience that got you that great round of applause that I promised would happen at the end of, or at the second half of this show, not at the end of the show. So we're going to come right back. Don't go away. We're talking with Katie Maris, who is the author of Custom Her Experience. And don't go away. This is an amazing business radio episode you don't want to miss. We'll be right back.
One of my favorite sayings is that customer service isn't a department. It's a philosophy. And it's a philosophy that must be embraced by everyone in the organization all the time, and that's 24/7. So if customer service is important to you, and I know it is, then you will love our virtual training, the ultimate on-demand customer service and experience training program that you can access anytime, anywhere. Now, the course content applies to everyone, regardless of position and responsibility, from senior executives to the most recently hired and everyone in between. You'll discover tips, ideas, and strategies that won't cost your company a fortune, but will produce what I call moments of magic, those positive experiences, and it will happen at every level of your organization. So go to Customer Service VT. That's V as in virtual, T as in training. That's CustomerServiceVT.com. It's time to get customer focused.
You're listening to Amazing Business Radio with best-selling author and customer service and business expert, Shep Hyken.
We are back on Amazing Business Radio talking with Katie Maris, and we are talking about everything related to why you should deliver a great experience, and that everything is increased business, double revenue in 36 months, increased loyalty. And we talked a little bit about the woman shopper. We're getting into AI, and I was going to ask you, there are companies that have gone too far where they say you can no longer talk to a human being. And I don't know, we have an airline here in the U.S. You're up in Canada. Is there any airlines up in Canada that have taken that direction?
Not any that I deal with because I wouldn't deal with them. So I had no.
Oh, wait. So you, if one of these airlines called you or any company that says, nope, we've gotten rid of our AI or of our customer support department, we're just using AI, will you still work with this? Would you say absolutely not? Or would you
absolutely
go in
not.
there with the idea of, I'm going to change these people and prove
Well,
to them?
I would love to do that because they would need someone like me and you in order to do that. But no, I would not be a consumer of their product.
Ah, that's different than working with them and trying to change them. Yeah, that's a good point. There is now on the flip side, our customer service research that we do every year just came out. I don't remember all the stats, but this one stood out to me. 26% of customers said if the company doesn't offer self-service support, they would not do business with them, which is the opposite of you. And by the way, can you guess the average age of that customer?
I mean, I'm assuming like the 18s to the...
They're the young ones. They're the young ones. Customers that want it. Yeah. So we asked, what's your preference? If you needed to call or you needed to get help, support, deal with the complaint, would you rather call or would you rather do it self-service? And 70% said phone call. So the phone is still alive and kicking, which is an important thing. So Frontier Airlines here in the U.S., I thought it was a very bold move for them to say, we're not going to do live customer support anymore. And I think it's been difficult. I think it's the future, at least the future for basic needs. There needs to be some level of contact when there's a problem. I mean, what happens if I need to get from, I live in St. Louis and I'm getting ready to fly to you in Toronto, and I've decided to book Frontier or any airline that doesn't offer human support, and I get a notice, your flight has been canceled. Here are two other flights that you can take today. And I look at them and I go, those don't work for me. Is there another way? I can't figure it out. I mean, there is some way. I mean, there is some interaction that happens with the bot, but it's tough to do.
Yeah. So that's an example of an extreme organization. And I just don't think, I think they're going to, the amount they think they're saving, they're going to lose in customer bookings. I think
I'm not so sure it's about saving money. I'm in sync with you related to, I am concerned for the company that goes that far. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm kind of enamored with the company that would take a chance and do it. And I want to understand everything going on now that they've made that. And so, with a little luck, maybe I'll get somebody from Frontier on this show.
That would be,
because I want to hear, is it working? And tell me what you've heard. Tell me the good, the bad, the ugly, and the interesting.
You know? I that would be an incredible show. Oh my goodness. I'd love to unpack that as well. Definitely. And I don't know. I mean, part of it has got to be savings. Part of it is maybe they're just, tailoring their experience to the new generations, the up and coming, the ones that are traveling all the time and don't really want to deal with humans. But it's only 26% that said that, right? In your stat.
Right. 26% said they would not do business with a company that didn't offer it. I think that there is another stat that's pretty high that says that they've had success with it. I don't remember all of them. There were so many. I've just written up the report. And as much as I've been writing it and studying it, there's so many numbers in my head. I'm so confused. but it's interesting how many people say that it is the future, that they expect it to be part of the future. Even if they're not loving it right now, they know it's coming. They're starting to trust it more. Some say, I don't trust it at all. It scares me. But hey, we don't have a ton of time. And we promised our audience five steps to a five-star experience. Okay. All right. Ready, set, go.
Go. Okay. So what you say and how you say it matters. It's really, really important that's step one. It's really, really important that we focus on the language we use, using full sentences, not using slang, and the tone in which you say a sentence or interact with your customer in conversation. And the reason why the tone is so important is because, gosh, tonality is something no matter where you are in the world, what language you speak, especially for call centers where you're hiring people that are out in different countries. We all know when our significant other says our name in a specific way, we're in trouble, right? Or when a mom says a child's name in a specific way, they know they're in trouble. The tone of which we use is universal. And so we have to focus on what you say, but how that tonality, how you say it matters.
Number two. Yeah. I got a funny story. I just remember my name is Shep, short for Shepherd. My company's name is Shepherd Presentations. Nobody ever calls me Shepherd, except my mom used to call me Shepherd when she was mad at me. Shepherd, come here. Yeah. Okay, I'm in trouble now.
But that's it, you know, right? And so when you're frustrated or upset or angry, you've got something going on and you're servicing a customer, that comes out in your tone. And so you have to check that at the door, because the customer will feel that even if you're not trying to have them feel that. So what you say and how you say it matters.
Very good. Number two
is use your name and use their name. Break down those walls immediately. Create that instant connection. Use their name.
Amen.
Number three is connect genuinely. Be genuine, because it's really important that the customer feels like you actually care, not that you have to care. So having that genuine connection is extremely important. Number four.
Wait, before we get into that, let's combine number two and three. If I use your name over and over again, somewhat ingenuously, just because I'm told to use your name, that's using your name, but not doing number three, which is being genuine. So we need to, if we're going to be talking to customers, and by the way, it's also people you work with. It doesn't matter when you're communicating. This is a five-star experience with every type of person you, and even your partner, spouse, significant other, and kids, right? So back to the, you know, we need to be sincere, and we also need to, we're going to hire people, and this is real important. Look at their communication skills and their style, because that's really important. By the way, somebody that doesn't seem to be able to come across genuinely, even if they are, that's a perfect person to use for chat customer support. You don't need to hear the inflection. So there is a place, regardless of the type of personality you have. All right, number four.
Okay, number four. This is my favorite. Anticipate their needs and deliver the plus one. Collect those golden nuggets, because we will, as consumers, we love talking about ourselves. We will give you all the information you need in order to elevate that experience by listening and receiving what they're saying, collecting those golden nuggets, then using it to elevate the experience.
So let me ask you a question. Let's say I'm out with my wife. I'm at a restaurant. We're talking. It's her anniversary. The server overhears it's her anniversary. Then they surprise us with a little cake and a candle and a happy anniversary gift at the end, you know, like just a dessert. I believe that's kind of the over the top experience. They've taken advantage of something, but they can't do that every time, because they're not going to get that nugget every single time. So how do you manage the expectation?
Yeah. So you mean the expectation of the consumer or of
the expectation of that guest, consumer, customer saying, wow, that was a great experience. I can't wait to see what they're going to do with me the next time.
Well, it really goes down to, like, I've told the story a thousand times out there, but like I was flying into Singapore. I got into my cabin. I was going to train the teams on board Celebrity Cruises. I was so, so tired. Got a call from the passport off the documentation office, and they're like, we need your passport. I'm like, I'm in bed. I have a headache. Is there any way I can give it to you tomorrow? Well, they took that information and they said, okay, we'll come to you. Number one. Number two, they brought me some Tylenol and a bottle of water. So while it wasn't an over-the-top experience, they anticipated my needs. They listened to what I said. So it doesn't mean you have to do a big gift every time. It's about tailoring that experience for that moment. And that is what the customer's looking for.
I love that. Great example. Great example. All right. I want to go to Singapore and be on a celebrity cruise. That sounds like fun.
It was amazing. It was phenomenal. It was.
All right. And number five.
Be a hero. So we are humans. We talk about bots versus humans. When we are interacting with humans, as humans, we're going to drop the ball. It's just reality. We need to have a positive way to deal with the lack of service or the dropped ball. So service recovery is so important, because you can gain better loyalty through the recovery than even the experience you design. And so it's really important to step up, be a hero, and have that service recovery in place.
Yeah, I often say that the way we recover doesn't just fix the problem. It fixes the customer. It fixes the confidence. So you don't just fix a problem. You actually, you restore confidence is the word. All right. So we're down to the end of the interview. You know, this question's coming. I've asked you this before. Is there one last nugget of wisdom you want to share with us today?
Yeah. I mean, I think the last bit of wisdom that I will put out there is to really hammer home that we are humans delivering an experience to humans, and we can't lose sight of that. And so while technology is amazing and there is a place for it, we can't lose sight that humans are the one, you know, opening up their wallets and purchasing from you. So we need to be able to find a way to marry that together.
I love it. Well, this is great. This is why we call it Amazing Business Radio. Another amazing interview. Katie, thanks for being back on the show.
Thank you for having me.
All right, everybody, that wraps it up. Another interview, and we will be back next week. And I promise you, it will also be a great interview. Until that time, this is Shep Hyken, and I'm reminding you to always be amazing.